क्वेश्चन नंबर 44। ओके सो लेट्स स्टार्ट। फॉलोइंग इज द बैलेंस शीट ऑफ फाइन प्रोडक्ट्स लिमिटेड एज एट 31st मार्च 2020। सो करेंट ईयर एंड प्रीवियस ईयर इज गिवन। शेयर होल्डर फंड, शेयर कैपिटल, वेयर इट विल गो, फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी, रिजर्व एंड सरप्लस, दिस विल गो इन ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी, ट्रेड पेबल ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी, अदर करेंट लाइबिलिटीज ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी, शॉर्ट टर्म प्रोविजन, वी विल सी वॉट इज गिवन इन शॉर्ट टर्म प्रोविजन, नोट नंबर 2, इट इज प्रोविजन फॉर टैक्स, सो इट विल ऑल्सो गो इन ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी, देन टेंजिबल एसेट्स विल गो इन इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी, इन टेंजिबल एसेट्स अर्लियर इट वॉज 50, नाउ इट इज 40, सो इट विल गो इन ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी, नॉन करेंट इन्वेस्टमेंट विल गो इन इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी, इन्वेंट्री इज ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी, ट्रेड रिसीवेबल ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी, कैश एंड बैंक, कैश एंड कैश इक्विवेलेंट, जनरल रिजर्व विल गो इन ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी, ट्रांसफर टू रिजर्व, सरप्लस ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी, प्रोविजन फॉर टैक्स ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी, लैंड एंड बिल्डिंग इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी, प्लांट एंड मशीनरी इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी। ओके चिल्ड्रन, देयर इज वन एडजस्टमेंट विच इज गिवन, प्रपोज्ड डिविडेंड ऑन इक्विटी फॉर द ईयर एंडेड 31st मार्च 2020 and 2021 आर 39,045। So this 39,000 of previous series of our use, this will go in operating activity add and in financing activity we will subtract. This is the treatment of this 39,000 proposed dividend. So let's begin, dear children. First activity is cash flow from operating activity. Cash flow from operating activity. Okay, so let's begin. From where we begin? We begin with reserves and surplus. What is given? It is given surplus. Earlier it was 18, now it is 27. So 9,000 rupees. Surplus 9,000. Then we add some appropriations, dear children, hai na? So let's add first provision for tax of current year. Let's see how much it is given. Provision for tax of current year is given 32,000, hai na? 32,000. Then we add transfer to general reserve. Transfer to general reserve is given. Earlier it was 20, now it is 30, means 10,000. Then proposed dividend of previous year. How much it was? Proposed dividend of previous year was given 39,000. Hai na? So 39,000. And what else is given? Provision for tax, general reserve, surplus, all points are over here. Okay, so let me do the total. 9,000 plus 42,000 plus 39,000 is equal to 90,000. This 90,000 will be your net profit before tax. Then we add next step, that is non-cash expense. Let us see depreciation is given or not. So children, in this question you can see non-current assets, tangible assets are given and note number is given 3. So under tangible assets, land and building is given and plant and machinery are given. Differences are given, isn't it? So depreciation is not given and we cannot calculate. So goodwill, let's see goodwill is given or not. Upper side, intangible assets, goodwill is given. Earlier it was 50, now it is 40, means decrease in goodwill means decrease in intangible asset. This is amortization. amortization of goodwill. Amortization of goodwill, 10,000 will be added. Okay, and then okay, so non-operating expenses are also not given, and non-operating incomes are also not given. Both are not given. So 90 plus 10, it will be 1 lakh. That will be considered as operating profit before working capital changes. And then we need to do some adjustment for working capital. Adjustment for working capital changes. Let's see some differences in current assets and current liabilities. So we start with current liability. Increase in trade payable. 35, 45, 55, 20, 18,000. Increase in trade payables. Increase in trade payables by rupees 18,000. It will inflow of cash. Then other current liability is decreased by 2,000. Decrease in other current liability by 2,000 result in outflow of cash. Short term provision is over. Provision for tax we have seen, hai na? Provision for tax of current year is already added up at the top. Then non-current assets, sorry, current assets will come. Inventories, there is a decrease in inventories. 39, 49, 59, means 18,000 decrease in inventories. Decrease in inventories will result in inflow of cash, 18,000. Then trade receivable, increase in trade receivable. Increase in trade receivable result in outflow of cash. And 75, 25 plus 8, 33,000 outflow of cash. So all points are over here. And then we need to subtract tax paid, 28,000. So first we do the total. So let me do the total. 1,18,000 minus 2,000 plus 18,000 minus 33,000 is equal to 1,01,000. Now whatever comes, we subtract tax paid, and the provision for tax which is given, and of the opening previous balance, and that will be considered as tax paid. So that is tax paid 28,000. Let us subtract 28,000. 1,01,000 minus 28,000. So it must come 73,000. Anna? Check 73,000. Yes, cash flow from operating activity. Positive value. Cash flow from operating activity. Positive. Then the second activity is cash flow from investing activity. Cash flow from investing activity. And what do we write in investing activity? We write non-current assets and non-current investment. Hai na? So let's see what is given in non-current asset. Begin with tangible fixed assets. Earlier it was 1,10,000, now it is 57,000. So it is decreased by 43 and 10, 53,000. So it is sale of land and building. Sale of land and building by 53,000. It result in inflow of cash, sale of land and building. Then plant and machinery, earlier it was 90, now it is 1,91,000. So it means it is increased by 1,01,000, है ना? Yes, so purchase of plant and machinery. Purchase of plant and machinery 1,01,000 result in outflow of cash, isn't it? And what else is given? Let me just check. Non-current investment was also given in this question, na? Yes, non-current investment is also given. Earlier it was 10, now it is 35. It means purchase of non-current investment by 25,000. Purchase of non-current investment by rupees 25,000 result in outflow of cash. Let me do the total. 53,000 minus 1,01,000 minus 25,000 is equal to 73,000 in negative. It comes in negative, it means it is cash used in investing activity. Cash used in investing activity. Okay, then third activity which is left, that is cash flow from financing activity. Cash flow from financing activity. Okay. So under financing activity, what we write? Shareholder fund plus non-current liability. Hai na? So let's see shareholder fund. Equity share capital, earlier it was 3 lakh, now 3,50,000. Issue of share capital, equity share capital 50,000. Issue of equity share capital by rupees 50,000. Then non-current liabilities are not given here. Then let's come in adjustment. In adjustment, proposed dividend was given on equity share. So it is to be paid, proposed dividend paid 39,000. Proposed dividend paid 39,000, so it result in outflow of cash. 50 minus 39, 11,000. Positive value, so it means it is cash flow from financing activity. Let us do the total. So 73 minus 73 plus will be cancelled, so 11,000 will come. This is positive value, 11,000. So it will be known as net increase in cash and cash equivalent. What we do this, then we add, what we add? Opening cash and cash equivalent. How much it is given? Opening cash and cash equivalent, it is given 17,000. Hai na? When we add 17,000, what we get? We get 28,000, which is our closing cash and cash equivalent. It is given 28,000. Hello, dear children. So I hope the question is clear to everyone. क्वेश्चन नंबर 45। फॉलोइंग इज द बैलेंस शीट ऑफ मेवांका लिमिटेड एज एट 31st March 2017। हियर कैपिटल इज गिवन विल बी रिकॉर्डेड इन फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी, रिजर्व एंड सरप्लस, ऑपरेटिंग, लॉन्ग टर्म बोरोइंग विल बी इन फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी, ट्रेड टेबल्स, ऑपरेटिंग, शॉर्ट टर्म प्रोविजन विल गो इन ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी। ओके, लेट्स सी व्हाट एल्स इज गिवन। प्रॉपर्टी, प्लांट एंड इक्विपमेंट विल बी रिकॉर्डेड इन इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी, इन्वेंटरीज इन ऑपरेटिंग, ट्रेड रिसीवेबल इन ऑपरेटिंग, कैश एंड कैश इक्विवेलेंट विल बी रिकॉर्डेड इन कैश एंड कैश इक्विवेलेंट, एंड अदर करेंट एसेट्स विल बी रिकॉर्डेड इन ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी। इन नोट्स टू अकाउंट, सरप्लस इज गिवन विल रिकॉर्डेड इन ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी, लॉन्ग टर्म लोन इज गिवन विल बी रिकॉर्डेड इन फाइनेंसिंग, प्रोविजन फॉर टैक्स ऑपरेटिंग, मशीनरी इन्वेस्टिंग, एंड बाय द यूज ऑफ एक्युमुलेटेड डेप्रिसिएशन वी विल कैलकुलेट करंट ईयर डेप्रिसिएशन दैट विल बी रिकॉर्डेड इन ऑपरेटिंग एक्टिविटी। सम एडिशनल इन्फॉर्मेशन आर गिवन हियर। सो एडिशनल लोन वॉज टेकन ऑन 1st July 2016, so we will remember we need to calculate for April, May, June for 3 months and then for 9 months. Okay, tax of 53,000 was paid during the year. It means we need to prepare provision for tax account. So children, first we will prepare a provision for tax account and then interest on loan. Okay, continue, let's start. Question number 45. First I will prepare working note for provision for tax account. Provision for tax account. Okay, debit side, credit side. Provision for tax account starts from credit side. We write opening balance. First we write by balance brought down. How much opening is given? Opening balance of provision for tax is given 70,000. So 70,000. Closing is given 68,000. Balance CD. To balance carried down 68,000, and in adjustment it is mentioned 53,000 tax was paid during the year. So tax paid will be recorded in debit side 53,000. What do we write? We write to bank account. This is tax paid, dear children. Anna, remember this is tax paid. Now let us do the total. Let's see how much balance is remaining. So 53,000 plus 68,000 is equal to 1,21,000. So 1,21,000 is the total. Find 1,21,000 minus 70,000 is equal to 51,000. So balance is remaining 51,000 in credit side. What we call it? This is by statement of profit and loss. This is our current year provision for tax, children. Current year provision for tax. Okay. Now we need to prepare one more working note for interest on loan. So let's see how much it is given. So long term loan. Can see 70,000 was in long term loan was given 60,000 opening balance and closing balance is 80,000. It means 20,000 loan has been taken. But when it has been taken? So it has been taken on 1st July. So first we calculate for 3 months 60,000 rupees. Rate of interest is 10%. So first we calculate 10% interest only for 3 months, because after 3 months 20,000 rupees is raised. 20,000 rupees is raised and now loan is of rupees 80,000. So now we will calculate interest on loan for rupees 80,000, 10%. Now we will calculate for 9 months, है ना? So let me calculate 60,000 into 10%, 6,000, 1/4, 1500, and 8,000, 8,000 divided by 3/4. Is equal to 6,000. It means interest on loan is 7,500. I hope these two working notes are clear to all of you. Hai na? Let's begin cash flow statement. Cash flow statement. First activity is cash flow from operating activity. Cash flow from operating activities. Okay. From where do we start? We start from surplus. Surplus is given here, children. Earlier it was 120, now it is 25. Surplus is given, but it is negative, it is loss. So 120 minus 25 is equal to 95,000 loss. Right? So for it showing loss, I will put bracket here for negative value. Right? So surplus is 95,000. Now we need to add some provisions. Let us see what provisions are given. So current year provision we have computed 51,000, you can see here. Right? We write current year provision for tax. Provision for tax of current year, that is 51,000, isn't it? 51,000 you can see here. Okay, let's see some other provisions are given or not, like dividend, proposed dividend, so it is not given, and a transfer to reserve is also not given. So let us solve it. 95 and 51, so it will remain 44,000 negative balance. What we call it, net profit before tax, but it is negative, so it will be considered as net loss, isn't it? And then we need to add non-cash expenses. Let's see what non-cash expenses are given. So first is depreciation. So we will take out the difference of these two, 48,000 and 23,000. Enough. So 48 minus 23 is equal to 25,000. So that is our current year depreciation. Depreciation of current year. 25,000. Then let's see if there are any intangible assets given above. So intangible assets are not given, means there is no amortization, right? So only that much value is given. Then we need to add non-operating expenses. And under non-operating expenses, we have taken out interest on loan. Interest on loan is non-operating expenses. It is not regular expenses. How much we have computed? 7,500 we have computed. And let's see if any other non-operating expenses are given. So nothing is given. Then what we do, we subtract non-operating incomes, and non-operating incomes are also not given in this question. So let us do the total. 44 is in minus, 5,000 plus 7,500 minus 44,000 is equal to 11,500. दिस इज योर ऑपरेटिंग लॉस, वी कैन से ऑपरेटिंग प्रॉफिट कम्स इन नेगेटिव, है ना, बिफोर वर्किंग कैपिटल चेंजेस, बिफोर वर्किंग कैपिटल चेंजेस, बट इट इज लॉस, इट इज इन नेगेटिव. देन वी नीड टू डू सम एडजस्टमेंट फॉर वर्किंग कैपिटल चेंजेस, एडजस्टमेंट फॉर वर्किंग कैपिटल चेंजेस. लेट्स सी अबाउट द डिफरेंसेज ऑफ करेंट एसेट्स एंड करेंट लाइबिलिटीज. ओके, सो लेट्स सी फर्स्ट अबाउट करेंट लाइबिलिटीज. ट्रेड टेबल्स आर गिवन, अर्लियर इट इज 20, नाउ इट इज 6, सो डिक्रीज ऑफ ट्रेड पेबल्स बाय रुपीज 14,000. डिक्रीज इन ट्रेड पेबल्स, मिनट, डिक्रीज इन ट्रेड पेबल्स बाय रुपीज 14,000. डिक्रीज इन ट्रेड पेबल्स रिजल्ट इन आउटफ्लो ऑफ कैश, है ना, शॉर्ट टर्म प्रोविजन इज ओवर. देन लेट्स कम ऑन इन्वेंट्रीज, इंक्रीज इन इन्वेंट्रीज बाय 7,000. इंक्रीज इन इन्वेंट्रीज बाय 7,000 रिजल्ट इन आउटफ्लो ऑफ कैश. देन ट्रेड रिसीवेबल, डिक्रीज इन ट्रेड रिसीवेबल बाय 14,000. डिक्रीज इन ट्रेड रिसीवेबल by 14,000 result in inflow of cash. Then other current assets, decrease in other current assets by 4,000. Decrease in other current assets by rupees 4,000 result in inflow of cash. All points are over here, isn't it? Current assets and current liabilities. Now let's us do the total. So minus 11,500, minus 14 and 7, 21,000, plus 14 plus 4, 18,000 is equal to 14,500 negative, isn't it? Now what we need to do, we need to pay tax less tax paid. So how much tax is paid during the year? It is given in the adjustment. Tax of 53,000 was paid during the year. Tax paid 53,000. Hai na? So let's solve it. So 14,500 and 53,000. It will be 67,500 negative. So this will be known as cash used in operating activities. Yes or no, children? Let's begin the next activity, second activity, that is cash flow from investing activity. Cash flow from investing activity. What do we write in investing activity? We write non-current assets and non-current investment majorly. These two heads are considered. So let's begin. We start with non-current assets. Let's see what is given. So you can see only machinery is given. Property, plant and equipment. So let us take their difference, 384 and 215, 384 minus 215, so 169,000. It means machine of rupees 169,000 is purchased, hai na? So purchase of machinery, purchase of machine 169,000. Negative value, है ना, and you can see nothing is given other than property, plant and equipment in this question. So only this one point is there, है ना, so the total will be 169,000 cash used in investing activity, cash यूज्ड इन इन्वेस्टिंग एक्टिविटी, है ना? एक्टिविटी इज कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी, कैश फ्लो फ्रॉम फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी। तो व्हाट डू वी राइट इन फाइनेंसिंग एक्टिविटी? मेजरली अंडर शेयर होल्डर फंड एंड नॉन करेंट लाइबिलिटीज, दीज टू मेजर हेड्स आर रिकॉर्डेड हियर under financing activity. So let's begin. What is given? Shareholder fund, you can see earlier it was 1 lakh, now it is 3 lakh. So issue of share capital by 2 lakh. Issue of share capital by 2 lakh result in inflow of cash, hai na? Then you can see long term borrowing. Earlier it was 60,000, now it is 80,000. So increase in long term borrowing, increase in long term borrowing by rupees 20,000, 60 to 80, you know, 20,000. Then you can see loan was taken, means interest on loan also we have to pay, and we have computed interest on loan 7,500. So interest on long term borrowing, that was 7,500. So 7,500 paid. I hope all the points are over. So let me calculate. 2,20,000 minus 7,500. So 2,12,500 positive value. So what we call it? We will use to say cash flow from financing activity. Cash flow from financing activity, isn't it? Now we add these three: 2,12,500 minus 1,69,000 and minus 67,500 minus 67,500. So it is coming 24,000 negative. So this will be known as net decrease in cash and cash equivalent. Net decrease in cash and cash equivalent. Now what we do? What we do? We add opening cash and cash equivalent. Opening cash and cash equivalent. Let us check how much it is given in the question. Opening cash and cash equivalent, it is given 49,000. 49,000. And when we solve, what we get? We get 25,000. That is equal to closing cash and cash equivalent. Closing cash and cash equivalent, hai na? I hope it is clear to everyone. Yes, dear children. Is it clear to everyone?